Hi everyone, good day. We'll be having our orientation for new business registrants. To aid our discussion, we have 7 modules for that. First, application for business registration. Second, application for registration of books. Third, invoicing requirements. Fourth, you are now ready to start your business. Fifth, file and pay your taxes. 6. Update your registration. 7. Retirement of business.
Let us now proceed to Module 4, which provides guidelines on how to start your business. These documents must be displayed conspicuously in the place of business. Certificate of Registration or Form 2303 and Notice to Issue in Invoices. The list below shows the principal and supplementary documents. The following are considered as principal documents: sales invoice, commercial invoice, cash invoice, charge or credit invoice, service invoice, and miscellaneous invoice. The following are considered as supplementary documents: official receipts, delivery receipts, order slips, debit or credit memo, purchase order, job order, provisional or temporary receipt, acknowledgement receipt, collection receipt, cash receipt, bill of lading, and statement of account. For VAT purposes, supplementary documents are not valid proof to support claim of input taxes by the buyers or purchasers of goods and services. The phrase, "this document is not valid for claim of input tax," shall be conspicuously printed at the face of each supplementary document. So when should you issue invoices? For non-VAT sellers, when customer demands for it, when sale of goods or services rendered are valued at 500 or more, if sales per transaction is below the threshold, but the aggregate sales amount at the end of the day is at least 500, the seller will issue one invoice for the aggregate sales amount for such sales at the end of the day. The non-VAT invoice must contain a statement that the seller is a non-VAT registered person, seller's TIN and branch code, registered business address of seller, the date of transaction, and the serial number printed prominently. Furthermore, it must also contain the registered name of the purchaser, their registered business address, their TIN, the quantity, unit cost, and description of goods or properties or services. This is an example of a sales invoice for a non-VAT registered taxpayer.
As you can see in the header, the seller's registered name, address, non-VAT registration status, and TIN are indicated in the header. It is also clearly labeled as an invoice, and the date of the transaction is specified. Furthermore, it is also essential to indicate the purchaser's name, address, and TIN. As to the goods sold or services rendered, quantity, unit cost, and the description of the goods or services must also be indicated.
For VAT sellers, they must always issue invoices regardless of the amount, whether cash or on account. The VAT invoice must contain a statement that the seller is a VAT registered person, seller's TIN and branch code, VAT amount is shown as a separate item. For VAT exempt or zero rated sale, it must be written or printed indicating the breakdown of the sale price and calculation of VAT on each portion of the sale. Seller may issue separate invoices for the taxable, exempt, and zero-rated components of the sale. Furthermore, the VAT invoice of a VAT seller must contain the date of transaction, quantity, unit cost, and the description of goods or properties or services. If purchaser is VAT registered and sales made is 1,000 pesos or more, it is required to indicate the registered name of the purchaser, the address of the purchaser, and their TIN. For a principal invoice or receipt to be valid for claim of input tax by a VAT registered purchaser, all information requirements must be shown. Note that for non-VAT and VAT sellers, If sale of goods or services are directly between a business and consumer, who are the end users, the business address and TIN of the purchaser are not required to be included.
This is an example of a VAT registered invoice. Just like a non-VAT registered invoice, seller's essential information are indicated in the header. It is also clearly labeled as an invoice and date of transaction is specified. Essential information pertaining to the purchaser as well as details on the goods sold or services rendered is indicated. However, for VAT registered taxpayers, they must indicate the VAT amount as a separate item.
These are some penalties under RMO 7-2015. For a more detailed list of penalties, you can refer to RMO 7-2015 found on the BIR website. For bookkeeping requirements, books of accounts must be properly maintained. It should be kept in the place of business and must be updated in record. Also, all entries in manual book of accounts shall be handwritten. For the preservation of manual books of accounts and manual bound loose leaf books, it must be preserved for 5 years in hard copies. For computerized books of accounts, it must be preserved for 5 years in electronic copies. Taxpayer whose annual gross sales or receipts exceed 3 million pesos shall have their books audited and examined yearly by independent CPA and their income tax return attached with account information form. How should you record your transactions? For simplified books of accounts, this is an example on how you can record your transactions for your daily sales for the month and cash receipts. This is an example on how you can record your transactions on your general journal. And this is an example for your subsidiary journal. Lastly, for general ledger, you can record your transactions by the following. Revenue officers are tasked regularly to conduct tax mapping operations to check the taxpayer's compliance on the books of accounts, invoicing requirements, and registration requirements. How to identify an official TCBD operation? The revenue officer conducting the operation must have a mission order. They must be wearing their official BIR identification card. They must provide a tax information sheet. And if there are violations upon inspection, the revenue officer must provide a violations checklist. And lastly, they must provide the taxpayer a tax map sticker. Note that for payments for compromise penalties on violations noted during TCBD should be made only through authorized agent banks.
For more information, you may visit us at our office, RDO 132, located at Botan Extension, Davao City, or contact us through the following numbers, or visit our official website, bir.gov.ph, or follow and message us on our official Facebook pages.